From the smallest microbes in the ocean moving toward the sun, to the light-sensitive cells in your retina, opsins are one of the biological bridges between light and life. These proteins convert light into signals that cells can understand. Twenty years ago, scientists learned to use these proteins to control neurons with light, creating the field of optogenetics.
It allows you to ask about causality in neuroscience, like what happens when I make these neurons fire. This is pretty different than watching neurons fire.
But these tools have always needed bright lasers or LEDs to work. We wanted to change that.
When biology has a problem to solve, biology makes a protein. Thanks to AI and other progress, our ability to engineer new proteins is advancing very rapidly.
We take either a natural existing opsin that exists in nature somewhere, or one of the mutants that we've generated that we found is better than the natural version, and we can mutagenize it further to identify new mutations that would further improve it.
To find out if our AI-engineered opsins actually work, we use a process called patching. It gives us electrical access to cells so we can test how they respond to light.
I do patch clamp electrophysiology on the Patrick Swayze machine. I'm responsible for collecting really refined single-cell recordings from our opsin-expressing cells. They are a high-quality zoomed-in look at single opsin function. The most important things that we're looking for is like, what is this opsin's favorite color? We're also looking at how sensitive is it.
But screening opsins one at a time, while good for getting a detailed understanding of promising leads, won't get us to our goal of a more responsive opsin. Enter Al Pacino, a machine we modified to let us screen opsins at scale.
This is the Al Pacino machine. We raised it up and we took off the bottom so that way we could shine our lasers up at the bottom of the plate. The auto-patch machine takes thousands of cells at a time, so we get a much higher throughput on the Al Pacino compared to the manual patch.
Combining these techniques led us to our new opsins, called WAChRs, that let us do something no channelrhodopsin has done before. They respond to ordinary room lighting. To test this, we did the simplest experiment we could think of.
We basically just put this new channelrhodopsin in two cells and then like put them in the dark. She just like lifted the curtain up and then, you know, we could see this like huge current flowing into the cell during that.
A lot of people like ran over and came to see what was going on.
You kind of like see it happening live and you're just like, oh, whoa.
We just made a set of opsins that makes a lot of work with optogenetics easier and faster with the ability to be less invasive.
We've tested over 1,750 opsins so far, and we're committed to sharing discoveries that advance optogenetics research.
We see ourselves as part of a global community. Anything that allows therapies to be developed faster, whether by us or others, is something that we're always going to support.
These new bridges between light and life are opening new opportunities.